You're listening to the AfterBuzz TV Network, now the largest new media platform on the web, and your number one source for after-show entertainment.
Very good, Keith
Johnson.
AfterBuzz Studios in Los Angeles, California, and streaming live on Ustream. This is AfterBuzz TV for TBS's Tyler Perry's For Better or Worse. We'll break down tonight's episode and get you all the latest For Better or Worse news and gossip. If you'd like to buzz in on tonight's show, you can buzz us at 424-256-1729. That's 424-256-1729. And now, picking up where the show leaves off, and the buzz continues, it's AfterBuzz.
Yes, she won.
Yes, indeed.
She won the chair dance off.
When there's no real music and people are already dancing in studio, you know we're about to have a good time.
You know you're hanging out with Spicy Mari.
Yeah, Jason, you were dancing though too.
I've been trying to catch up. It's been two episodes. She's got a different dance.
Wow. Okay.
Trying to learn.
It must have been that kind of episode on Tyler Perry's For Better or Worse. Ladies and gentlemen, checking us out on Ustream, YouTube, iTunes, basically everywhere on the internet. This is AfterBuzz. My name is Ronnie Jr. Going to be moderating, hosting, and of course, Spicy Mari is always right there.
Spicy Mari keeping it sizzling in here.
Yeah, dancing before any kind of music even played.
After
I love it.
TV.
Yeah.
Hey, I got Jason Olive.
Chair dance champion.
Most beautiful man in the world to my left.
And if you drive down anywhere in Los Angeles and you see the GNC ads, there goes this guy's face and body and all that.
So you know when you're a vegetarian like myself, you gotta take supplements.
There you go.
He's what you call gorge.
And Jason joins us every week, you know, recapping the show. It's a lot of fun. And he's part of the AfterBuzz family. Of course, we're going to talk about our guest in just one second. But let's say hello to our social media corner over there. They always get down.
Lauren Turner. Jason F. Daniels on the one.
Did
twos.
You really call him the wrong name?
Uh-oh.
You called him Jason?
I said Jesse. Jesse F. Daniels.
So that means, wait, your name's Jason. For better or worse, that's Jesse.
Jesse F. Daniels. Sorry, Jesse. I had a brain fart.
Jason's
over here.
Guru.
My body temperature is rising by the second.
Tech nerd.
I'm jealous now. I told you.
Are you nervous? Do you have nerves right now?
I have to be on best behavior because I have his love interest from the show. Right in front of me. I just want her to kick my ass.
Watch out, Spicy.
Yeah, this is about to get good.
We have beautiful Crystle Stewart in the building.
Yeah.
I mean,
do we
when
always
she's
have?
Around, we bow down.
I mean, Crystal, I'm very excited. I don't always have a Miss USA sitting next to me like this. I'm gonna be the one stuttering today. Really?
I mean, can you this duo right here, this combination, Jason Olive and Crystal Stewart? Come on now.
How do you compete with Jason?
This is like the most beautiful TV couple in the world.
I would say, and you guys are the couple.
I just figured
on the show.
We had Michael Jai White in here last time, so I figured, God,
we
got to give you something.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
You almost got your ass beat.
So. Yeah, with Michael Jai. Because I liked me. He was very,
you were like, you only have 6 black belts? And he was like, 7.
And I know. Anytime he had to, with authority, the voice had to go down. Well, let me tell you something.
People he killed in order to get those belts?
Yeah. Oh, my God. Crystal, you're here now, and the greatest thing about you showing up is you did some research. You knew exactly what you were going to get with the AfterBuzz. We love that.
I love AfterBuzz. I watched the show. Jason told me about it. I was like, oh, this is fun. Yeah. I couldn't wait to come. So I did my research. I know all about you guys. I know where you live.
Studied like a true queen.
There you go.
I left out the part about the headphones. We're going to mess up.
My
hair. I left that out, so we snuck that in on her. But.
So many good things at AfterBuzz, and let's talk about social media a little bit because I know you followed our show, which is great.
Yes.
You knew Kiki showed up. Mm-hmm. You knew Michael Jai showed up.
Yes.
But what you don't do a lot is tweet very much.
You're new to the Twitter world.
Just don't make fun of me.
It's support around here.
Your back, girl.
I'm not good at it, so I need your followers, you know, hopefully to follow me.
No, this one right here, she's a social media guru.
I tweet a lot. I have a lot of spicy tweets that I send out.
Oh.
So spicy tweet of the day is if you guys want to keep the flame burning, follow Crystle. What's your Twitter?
It's at Crystle Stewart. So it's spelled differently. It's CrystleStewart as in Tom, at Crystle Stewart.
Okay. So you guys hear that? Everybody start following her.
That means I have to really learn because I don't get like the hash and all this. Like,
the hashtag.
I really don't understand
it. Okay. Well,
I call it the pound.
You're doing really good. You're doing really good, Crystle. The last one you have right here is ladies, be there for your friends. Tell them what is right and what is true, not just what they want to hear at the moment. That was so relatable to this episode.
That was
eloquent.
So I was just making sure it went out then, so obviously it went out. Okay.
Oh, yeah, it was good. You're good.
I didn't even know if it tweeted.
You hit the button.
You're good.
It says tweet. I'm like, okay,
You say something, it goes out over the world.
No, for a while, I was tweeting myself.
How do you do that?
Because you put yourself in it. I tweet myself sometimes.
I didn't know.
I like to see my little photo pop up on my profile.
I like her. I'm going to follow her.
That's a little kinky. But, you know, we had a little talk as to what happened, and so Crystle got on Twitter and she was all excited, but her first experiences were
a little bit embarrassing.
It's embarrassing, but you're on AfterBuzz.
Yeah, okay.
I guess we talk about everything.
I thought it was funny.
Okay, well, since it's AfterBuzz, I'll tell. Okay, so my first tweet, I'm like so excited to get these tweets, and this guy is on it's really gross, but I'm gonna say
I love it already.
Should you bleep or what? I don't know. He's like, I want to masturbate to your legs.
Is that spicy?
That is gross. Yeah.
But then over here,
and she called me and she was like, "What do I do?" And I was just like, "Uh huh."
She called me.
Okay.
I was like, "What do I do with
normal?
That?
Natural?" Right.
No, what happened was a bunch of other men started following and saying things that are similar. So I was like, "Okay, I guess let them."
I mean, it's
so that was like response. She was like, "Well, I guess that's what Twitter's about." So.
Yeah,
a great response would have been tune in on Fridays.
Oh, yeah, if you want to see them legs.
My legs exclusively on
TBS. Little legs, little
cleavage. No, Twitter honestly is a really good tool, though. I mean, outside of that aspect, it is a little crazy. But for you, let's talk about you and being a rising star. I mean, this is an opportunity for you when you go do interviews, when you come to AfterBuzz, or maybe grace a cover of a magazine or whatever, because I know you got a lot going on. This is now a new tool for you, you know, on Twitter. So we're going to do our part at AfterBuzz to try to get her more followers.
I already know I got you.
And I want to talk to you because you
The only difference between a follower and a stalker is they don't know your address.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's the only difference.
And we want to talk about you, too, as far as, like, your career.
Okay.
You are the only one in this room that's a Miss Universe, or Miss USA.
Miss USA.
I'll take that.
Yeah. Lauren, were you Miss USA, too? No.
Only in my dream.
Okay.
But thank you for that compliment.
Okay. You are,
she could be that beautiful.
What is a Miss USA about? I mean, well, that's insane.
That's some competitiveness, right?
It was crazy. So I was Miss Texas first. You have to compete in your state, and it took me 5 times to win Miss Texas. The girls down there
that's
in Texas,
hustle.
They do not play. And I was the first African American to win. Mm-hmm. So it was a great, I won a Mustang. Mm-hmm. And so you only get one shot. So those 5 times competing as Miss Texas, it prepared me for my one shot at Miss USA. So went to Miss USA and won.
It
was a great experience.
It was all worth it.
Mm-hmm. Then went to Miss Universe and failed.
For those who haven't seen it, what happened?
Okay, so I went to Miss Universe. It was in Vietnam. That was my first time out of the country. So I thought I had a bullseye on my chest to begin with. It's like USA. But the Vietnamese were so amazing. So anyway, go there to compete, and you make the top 15 out of like 81 girls. So I made the top 15. They called Miss USA. I'm excited.
Nice.
So I competed in swimsuit, and I was the top 3. And then went on, you go on to top 10. So I got to top 10, and I competed in my evening gown. I'm ready, and I did my pose. I was going to step out, and I slipped. My dress was caught on the bottom of my shoe. It was like beautiful. I slipped and fell. Like, I didn't just, like, trip. I fell on my bottom.
Oh, my God.
And got back up. I kind of, like, clapped, and I kind of, like, slipped again because it was stuck. It was like I was on roller skates. But you know what? Things happen for a reason. I don't think that's, like, why I lost or anything, but... You know, the experience.
But you probably
and,
so good doing it,
And
though.
The recovery. I mean, that's what it is. Listen, I've seen the video. Yeah, she fell and immediately got up, did the clap, and really just, not the clap. She went like this.
She did the robot.
She did it, like, confident, and she was.
That's all I could do. I couldn't believe I fell.
That was grace.
You know, that was the second year in a row that a Miss USA tripped at Miss Universe.
And
it
that's
was a
like
sabotage.
I'm the only one that's never seen this.
I've never seen it.
That's the biggest pageant. Okay.
Well, you're
though.
You're busy on billboards. You don't.
That's
you
the biggest pageant
go on the
fear
internet.
To fall.
Yeah.
That's like forgetting your lines at American Idol.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You do not want to fall because evening gowns about grace and elegance.
Maybe that's why we're not getting married.
Wait a minute.
Fall.
Okay. Well, here we're gonna focus real quick. We could talk about this forever and ever, but no, that is great, Miss USA. You definitely did. You know, you did it. That's good.
I won Miss USA.
I want to talk about the transition into acting because I don't know if you had knocked around as an actress for years and years and years, and then the Miss USA, like what came first. But let's do something really cool just to kind of loosen things up. We'll do a photo gallery. I think if Phil has that ready. And of course, you guys could always hit us up, you know, on the phone lines or tweet us on AfterBuzz, all that good stuff. Phil, do we have the photo gallery ready, possibly?
I got one better for you. I got a caller. Photo gallery, we're experiencing technical difficulties.
Okay.
See, unlike other networks, we are the only network that will actually tell you that.
Yeah, we
well,
keep it
real.
Because
there's only five of us.
We keep it real.
This might be the gentleman that wants to hear AfterBuzz TV exclusive.
Well, let's go to the phone if we have a call,
let's
right?
Let's confront him.
Yes. Caller 919, you are on the line.
Hello?
Hello?
What's up?
Welcome.
Hi.
Hi.
Talk to us.
Oh,
what,
my gosh.
What's
I
your,
can't,
you can't
believe I'm actually on.
Believe
yes,
it.
Yes, AfterBuzz TV for better or worse.
Talk to us. Who are you here to talk to? Do you love Jason? Do you love the show?
I have a question Crystal? For Crystal.
Oh, ladies.
This guy.
Uh-huh.
Miss Crystal, my question is this. Do you and Mr. Perry have... another type of relationship outside.
Okay,
of-
next caller.
No, I can be very honest. Actually, he has a beautiful girlfriend. Her name is Galila. We're actually just really good friends, and I'm one of his actors on his show. But he's a really nice guy. All of us have a great relationship with him, all the characters. But he has a wonderful girlfriend.
I think that shifts into the question. Go ahead.
Mm-hmm. Oh, because he always seems to, you know. I don't know. It seems like he
kind of
has a little crush on you. So,
whoa! Oh, really? He's kind of like the rest of the world, and in awe with her
yeah.
beauty.
There's nothing wrong with the work crush. You wanna, you know, this is your staff or whatnot,
right.
or this is your team. These are the people you're. Cast members that you want to do well, so you want to be friendly with
exactly.
them. That totally makes sense.
I just
sense.
Want to put on the record that I did have dinner with Tyler once, and there was nothing sexual. That was on the whole. I just want to throw that out there.
That's your disclaimer
out there. Yeah. Was wondering.
There's
yeah,
your disclaimer.
Yes, we did go to dinner. No, nothing happened.
So for the
yeah.
record,
okay. no
the
romance.
Have a relationship
no,
like
there's
that.
No relationship. Not at all.
I do want to transition real quick and
three
questions.
Okay. I was just wondering.
No, the answer is no. I have a wonderful boyfriend at home waiting for me, but. Tyler's great, but
damn
he's not,
him.
We don't have a relationship.
Damn, Max.
Okay, thank you, guys.
Thank you. Do us a favor and keep tweeting and Facebooking us, okay?
Woo.
Thank you. Let's talk about the...
that was hot and heavy.
You know, so people... Tyler Perry, you know, that's that thing. You know, what is that audition process? I was assuming everything was really, really quick. For Kiki, she told us it was, boom, let's get on a plane the next day. We're shooting the next day. We kind of change our character. Like, so much happened with her. Was your story like that? Or
no, but what happened was I met Mr. Perry at a restaurant.
Okay.
I don't know if that helps my
story
at all. Am I undermining your whole...
I met Jason at a restaurant, too.
No,
look at us now.
Which,
I was
going
which
to
restaurant?
Meet...
We all, let's, well, we're all going to try to get casted in a show. Yeah. Granted, I'm not Miss USA, but still.
I was going to meet my boyfriend at the restaurant, and Mr. Perry was there. And the manager said, well, would you like to meet Mr. Perry? I was like, well, he's eating. Of course I want to meet him. But I was like, he's eating. I didn't want to bother him. And they're like, my boyfriend took him on himself. Introduced me. He said, would you like to meet Miss USA?
That's a strong boyfriend.
Right.
He is, yeah.
I know,
and
she's brought up the boyfriend thing like three times, just crushing everybody.
Yeah.
Anyhow.
So, we don't believe her.
I just have to say that. No, I'm kidding. So I went over
all these disclaimers.
So, and then he was like, I walked over to him. He was like, wait, I didn't know Miss USA was black. And so anyway, we sat and talked a bit. And he said, are you an actress? I was like, yes. He said, well, I have this new show coming out, and I would love for you to audition for it. You have
nice.
The look that I would like, and if you can act. I would love for you to be a part of the show. So his casting director called the next day I auditioned, and I got the job. And a couple
wow.
of months later, we were shooting for better or worse.
So that was kind of quick.
Everybody
season.
Had such yeah. an easy process on this except me.
Well, I'm the only one.
Ring of Fire.
I'm the only one. I went through like seven different casting sessions. Really? And then Ozzy, you know, Ozzy, the CEO of TPS, afterwards he texts me. He goes, "It was your role all along. Just wanted you to know." I go, "Man, can we just start there next time and work backwards? Because this is amazing."
Maybe you should have gone to the restaurant with her.
That's true.
I'm eating in the wrong places.
You're
going
to have to become Miss USA, and then that'll be it.
Well, real quick, to link it back to the show, a lot of fans are noticing you, and Lauren has a tweet from somebody right now.
I really do think you're a standout character. I mean, just personally, I think I've tweeted that. But
yeah, we're in shock.
How emotional. That's great.
We're like, oh my God.
Yes.
Stop tweaking out and just do the tech stuff. I told you,
really,
she's really pretty and cool. Get over it.
I'm like, I have to let Lauren handle this right now.
I mean, I think most of the followers, they agree. Leandra says, "I love the way the friend dresses on For Better. What's her name? She's beautiful too." Well, now if you're watching AfterBuzz, you do know her name is Crystle Stewart. And yeah, you do dress. The styling is amazing.
Could you guys tell us a little bit about that?
Because I know this is about you, and we'll get to our set, but I just want to say something about this. Originally, Leslie's style was very different. Okay.
It was.
Now, this is Crystle's second, am I right? Second, right? This is the second thing that she's ever done as an actress. So, all of us, I think mostly me, because I had to work with her every day, are sitting there going, how's this going to be?
Because she's a new actress.
And she comes to me and she goes, I don't know about these clothes. And my first thought was, shut up and wear them. I said, what about the clothes?
Yeah.
And she says, they're just not sexy enough. This is not what I wear.
Okay, this spicy is, Crystle.
And she said, this is not what I wear. And I was like, well, you know, God, that's definitely would be good for the show. Why don't you talk to some people about it? You know, because you're trying to stay out of it. You know, you've learned by now the kind of stuff. She has this discussion, and next thing you know, racks of clothes are coming down.
Racks on racks.
Coming
on
down
racks.
The hallway. Because the wardrobe was just like waiting for someone to say, please, can we just dress her how she looks?
Well, you know, the people
so
are
she
a lot
was
of people...
responsible for the clothes
that's great.
She's wearing.
That was my question.
That's
a lot of people are tweeting about the heels that the women are wearing. Angela, Leslie,
even Keisha. Yeah.
People wondering, you know, you got to match your shirt with your shoes, says toys with words. Like, I mean, you took control of that.
That's good, Crystle.
I don't want to sound like I was a diva because I didn't. I made sure, though. I talked to the stylist and I said, I really want to feel comfortable while I'm doing this. Can we work something out? And they're amazing stylists. And they said, okay, let's try to fine tune some things that would work for me and for Leslie and the character. So I didn't want to be trashy, but I want to be classy but sexy.
Right.
So hopefully, I think that's what Leslie
and
is
we've noticed on this.
That.
We've noticed on this show, like, you know, we asked you lived in Atlanta, a spicy Mahdi, you know, how authentic, you know, maybe some of the scenes are, and now you know, to be authentic with the look and for you to step up and say that maybe would be a risk. You're the new actress, but you just, you know, you had a confidence about it and you said it and it's good, and every TV show now needs that. Myself, Mahdi, and Jesse, we love a show called How to Make It in America because it keeps it so authentic, and they make sure the clothes are good, and they make sure the club scene
fresh.
Is good. Yeah,
and I mean, as I used to live in Atlanta, like the women take themselves very seriously. Hair did, nails did, everything did.
Yeah.
So I like.
Are you rapping right now?
I like that.
And just for the record, you're only a diva if you're wrong.
Oh, okay.
I like that even more.
Well, and you've been real sweet since we met you. This is the thing about it. Me and Mahdi, we do radio, and it's like interview celebrities all the time, but it's weird because it's like, hi, I meet you. Maybe you have a past relationship, of course, friendship or whatnot, but this is different. We got to watch a whole TV show with you for an hour and bond with you. So diva's not even really what we're thinking about. But Crystle, real quick, we do got some pictures for the photo gallery, and then we'll jump into the recap. We'll jump into the recap because there was a lot going on with Angela and cars and everything.
Yeah, I got some juice
so
to talk about.
So this is the photo gallery. I just wanted to talk about, you know, we have iTunes people that are checking us out right now. Tell us about what we're seeing right here in these photos. This is a press opportunity. And this is actually on the Facebook page of For Better, which we love because they show our videos.
And you have a mic in your hand.
Wow, you got pictures we've never even seen before.
Yeah.
I haven't seen that one.
But I think we were doing an interview. We were doing like a promo shoot for the show. And we were doing an interview with the TBS team, the director, I guess, of the show.
When we do the shoots together, normally this is how it goes. They focus the camera on her, and then I'm just off camera.
Yeah, of course.
I just want to give Tyler Perry props for casting, because you guys are an amazing looking couple. I mean, it's almost too good to be true. You guys are beautiful. I mean, I tune in just to watch y'all. and do AfterBuzz.
I think we have other photos. Phil, do we have other ones or is that part of? Ooh, oh, okay.
Ooh. Ow.
The reason I brought this one up, I mean, ow too, but I wanted to bring this one up because we all know that Tasha Smith right now is becoming that, not becoming, she's been, everyone wants to really enjoy her and like her, and she's becoming the star right now. So you are right next to her a lot, and you're playing like a best friend. What is that like? You're the new actress.
Yes,
this is Tasha,
so
who
amazing.
People have been rooting for years. I just need to know what you're thinking when you do scenes like this.
I know. I was worried about that. I'm like, you know, everyone already knows Tasha. They love her. They love her. Loves her. Wow. They love her. They loves is her.
No.
Killed. They killed. There's a D. They killed.
They killed. Killed with a D.
No, but Tasha is really an amazing woman. She's an amazing actress. She's an amazing wife. She's an amazing friend. And just shooting with her, anytime I needed help or advice or anything, she was there for me. So I was at ease, to be honest.
Now,
and
she's a star. And she's a coach. She's an acting coach.
She is.
Yeah, that's what Kiki was saying. Yeah.
Right. Oh, like, yeah. She was
girl,
great.
Maybe try it like this.
With T-Saw. She has what? T-Saw? I think
T-Saw,
that's what it's
yeah.
called. Mm-hmm.
Did you do the silly dilly like Kiki did also?
The silly dilly?
Did you know?
It's a method that Tasha teaches, she said.
Oh, yeah. No, I didn't do the silly dilly. Oh, look, no, I didn't do that.
Yeah. Was it Kiki Tasha Coco?
Yeah. Kiki Tasha Coco.
Oh, did Michael do that last week?
Michael did do that.
We got every single person who's been on.
Yeah.
We have to teach us something.
Yeah. You got
to
leave your mark, Crystle. Come on.
Oh, wait, I have to think about it. Give me time.
Well, we got.
But they did
minutes.
The Kiki Tasha Coco, but it never sounds right when he says Crystal. Like
I was
Kiki,
gonna say
Tasha
that.
Coco Crystal
and Crystal.
I don't like it.
Okay. Crystal's not
Jesse,
such a caveman thing.
Jesse can do it pretty
thing.
Good.
Yeah. Kiki Tasha Coco.
We'll collectively come up with a Crystal rap or something. All right.
Yeah.
Let's move on to another photo because we just put a couple. Okay, and this is again same idea. Tyler Perry's right there. You guys are doing press.
You see how he's looking at me too. See at me.
Oh, there goes that romance again.
He made this relationship, but he hates it. Look at him.
Yeah. Just you sitting there. You're sitting there, Crystal, with people that have large IMDb credits.
Yeah.
You are, of course, Miss USA, but you're. What does that feel like being the newer one on this? Particular.
I was, new on the acting scene, but I tell you, the cast is so great to me, and they're so nice. As soon as we met each other, we hit it off really well. I mean, Jason seriously has been really, really helpful. Anytime I had questions or I'm like, any personal things too, I'm like, hey, I need your help, or like with the wardrobe, I come to Jason, like, well, how do I do this? How do I approach this? And he always has the right, answer for me.
Well,
so
see, I'm married, so
really
I know
helpful.
How to say yes. Yeah, right. Yeah. I know how to say yes in 10 different languages. You don't even know I'm saying yes when I'm saying yes. You just got to find a way to say yes.
Just say yes. That's always the right answer.
He's
there you
always
go.
Honest
yes,
and true with
it
me.
Is,
he's
Ronnie.
A good listener, too.
Write
really
that down.
As a matter of fact, Ronnie, you are correct.
Yeah. Correct. There we go. I think we have one more photo, and then we have a funny one. There's the funny one. I think anyone can weigh in with an opinion. If you guys are on iTunes right now, we did a bunch of Crystal pictures, but we thought, his love interest happens to be this guy named Jason that hangs out with us.
Okay, look at that.
Crystal, you talk about it.
That's just wrong.
Crystal, I need you to explain what we're looking at right here.
What we're looking at is
your love interest.
My love interest, and he looks even better now, I must say. I think he's a few years ago. He's being good. He's being bad.
Is he lifting up his shirt a little bit?
He's trying to show, some nice goods for us. Doesn't he look amazing?
Calvin Klein.
Jason, what?
Go ahead. I'm sorry. When I first met him, I was like, this guy is awesome. He is so hot. And he's sweet, too, So.
He is. He's a sweet
What
guy.
Year was this?
Yeah, that's what we need to know.
Why are you going to ruin it?
No, because
don't you have some tweets or some information to send? We were on a roll. And now here you come.
Like I just remember being in
like
fifth grade.
The Grinch. Oh! Whoa! I don't know why I drive out here, Ronnie.
I'm just kidding.
That's why I drive out here.
Wow. I know. And you put in a lot of work, too.
There's
so that's
60 is closed. That's okay. True. There's
but
a windstorm outside.
Good,
I come out down all the way to the valley for this.
You look amazing. You look always. I mean, you look amazing now, and you looked amazing in 1984, too.
Yeah.
All
right.
Like fine wine, Jason.
All right. Clearly, we can talk about Jason's photo forever. Ladies and gentlemen, let's move into the recap. See, episode number 7 and 8. I can't believe the season is pretty much close to being over. Two more.
Lord, this isn't Ronnie. Wait, hold on. Let's be clear. This isn't the season at all. This is the pilot.
The pilot.
Okay, pilot.
That's
yeah.
what's crazy that's about all this. Wow. Who in the world does a 10-episode pilot?
Right.
The answer, nobody, except Tyler Perry. He's
so
the only person
in the world.
So as
soon as the pilot ends, we can expect more episodes?
Yeah.
Right. Right now.
So.
Right now, is it just a waiting game for you actors? And the numbers are in. That's the thing. Like that lead episode or one and two was 3.4 something.
Amazing
numbers. And I think what you guys are doing this live tweeting. And is it all six of you? I mean, I know you're tweeting.
Yeah. We're gonna try to have Coco next week. You better look out. You might want to switch seat. You better watch out.
Coco Jennifer. Yeah. Let's meet her.
Because she will have you cracking up laughing.
Real quick, let's talk about this is a baby mama drama in episode 7, and then episode number 8 is Speak Now. What were you guys' thoughts on the episode? We saw everything, including a waiting to exhale moment. Is that what we could,
Lauren, what were some of the people tweeting at you?
Oh my goodness.
There were some crazy ones.
There were some crazy ones. I took some notes of some of them. I Shimmy You Scream said, I would have burned the whole house down.
Oh, wow.
Whoa.
Wow.
Get out of here.
What mad woman said this?
What mad woman?
What three-time divorcee said that?
Yeah, that's crazy, because then she'd be up over our, Angela be in our house. And that's
some man should have told her yes, like you said, in 9 languages.
I mean, on the other side of things, Sincerely Trey actually says, you know, Marcus is the epitome of a good man. He didn't hit her.
Yeah.
Oh. So,
a lot of guys are giving credit to Marcus for handling it right.
Yeah,
I think so.
He was scary was his silence, though.
The
that
silence
was like,
scary.
That was
it
like
really
silence
was.
Of the lambs.
Yeah. That's when all of the women in this room connected, like, whoa, that's the worst.
Yeah.
That's the worst.
The problem was when, as angry as she was, she retaliated when she didn't. She still doesn't know 100% what was going on. She still didn't have enough evidence. So the way that she reacted was she was fighting fire with fire. Mm-hmm. And she just, I mean, she looked crazy in the scene, but it was a good scene.
It was, right?
It was so good. I'm
she,
sorry.
She, like, embodied so Angela Bassett.
Oh, yeah, and the way that they were showing Waiting to Excel in the beginning.
Yeah, to set it
to
up.
To set it
to,
up.
You know, yeah.
And then when she lit that car on fire.
I was hearing.
Cigarette.
I was like, you go.
I was hearing, like, the Mary J. Blige song in my head.
Yeah, right?
You know, I was like, wow, this is really happening. Even if you knew the scene was about to happen, it didn't matter. It was like everyone was kind of in tune with
and
it.
And there's
you know?
Some of those scenes that as actors, like, you can't do it without giving some homage, you know?
Yeah.
I mean,
well,
know,
yeah,
everyone
I thought
knows
that,
that scene.
Wasn't.
Everyone
yeah.
knows that moment. Mm-hmm. And, you know, hey, you know, the way I looked at it was like Angela was having a Tasha moment. You
she
know?
Was. Yeah.
I mean, Tasha was having
an Angela moment.
I'm like, yeah. No, she wasn't. Stop.
It was intense. And I think out of all the episodes we've seen on this pilot, which, you know, is crazy, 10 episodes, like you said, this was the one time Twitter lit up one, well, so far at least, the biggest, because no one, you know.
Oh, yeah. It's hard to even keep track. There's so many.
Even celebrities are tweeting about the show, which is nice. I mean, I know Steve Harvey supported you guys.
Yeah.
If you don't know much about the Twitter game, but a hashtag, Crystle, let me educate
okay,
you real quick.
Okay, my tutorial.
A hashtag is basically, Jesse and Lauren, of course, could co-sign on this, is when if you put the pound as
I say pound. Put the pound. Okay.
If you put the pound in front of a topic, it basically links right. up everything that has to do with that same topic.
Hashtag
so if you hashtag
me.
If you hashtag
for better
Leslie Shoes, mm-hmm. that means everybody that's on the Twitter community will all get linked up into the fact that they're
like
they're talking. Yeah, it's like a
Should
chat room.
Talking about the same thing
that
yeah.
they're talking about Leslie
okay.
Shoes.
So, pound for better. Everybody's talking about the show.
For better
so we're just giving all our opinions on what's going on.
And Crystle, most of the people that come in for AfterBuzz, they always put pound or hashtag AfterBuzz with Ronnie and Marty. Was so much fun. So you might want
to
do the same, young Crystle.
Jesse, what we got? Where's we do a hashtag Crystal's legs, Leslie's legs.
Oh,
hey, Jason, Twitter will shut down. Twitter won't make it, Jason.
I
if that
really quick,
I have the
give
best
us a personal,
job in the world.
You do. Inside tip. I mean, your legs are beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Cocoa butter girl, what do you
actually,
shave with?
You know what? I use Carrie lotion.
No,
it's I shave and I use Carrie lotion. I've used it for years. My mother used to put like Vaseline
Carrie
on it.
Lotion.
But it's Carrie lotion.
Wait, go
it's
back to
really
the mama
greasy.
Putting Vaseline on you. What?
She used to
I know
where
everyone's mind
down.
Is going.
Really?
That's so bad.
No, not
she
at all.
Used to
that's
not so
down
bad.
With Vaseline, so we wouldn't be ashy.
Yeah.
So
but that
from,
keeps the skin
it's
nice
soft,
and silky.
Yeah. And so I mean, Carrie lotion is very greasy, but throughout the day it kind of it soaks into your skin and it keeps it nice and
so you still
soft
use it till this day. Mama's recipe.
Carrot lotion. Well, you're
going to
get an advertisement.
Maddie is on it. Yeah. It's like we have amazing Crystal, and then we have amazing Maddie. Like, this is just.
Oh, yeah.
Jason and I don't even got to say anything.
Just use some mash avocados on me. You can't afford no lotion?
All right. Well, we do like to hashtag, you know, the good and the bad, for better or worse, right?
So the better and the worse.
I do have one from LJ Triple, says hashtag for better. Needs a studio audience. Kind of awkward when no one
I'm dying to talk about that.
That is on board with that.
Crystal, fire your opinion first. Let's go.
You know, I think what it is, we're used to not have. I mean, we're used to having that studio, that audience to know when to laugh. And if you think about it, just laugh when you think something is funny.
Do it yourself. You know, and many shows, I think Modern Family, I remember watching that, and I'm like, oh, not a laugh track. But it's okay, and you went with it, and all these shows on TV are doing it. Maybe this is the first for this genre, and this show just breaks any genre anyways.
That's true.
Because there was a part where I taking my notes, it was a good 10 minutes, 15 minutes, I was like, there's no dramedy today. This is the all drama episode, you know.
Michael and I told you last week about that. That last week was the turn. And now, you know, you're getting into the deeper part of the show. So even the fact that there was no laugh track, I mean, you see the genius of what Tyler's done. He's like, okay, I'm going to make all these changes. I'm not going to give you the laugh track, and it's going to be funny until now. And now you understand why there is no laugh track. Where will we put a laugh track in tonight?
Exactly.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Because you guys are telling a story, and that's number one.
And so it's kind of leading people along. We saw a lot.
Talk about a new genre. I mean, we have a tweet retweeted by Jason Olive. Really good guy.
Jason Olive.
Curious to know this guy.
I gotta tell you, your tweets when you do the show are really you're funnier than you are during the week. During the week, I'm like reading Jason's tweets, and I'm like,
buried today.
Well, I do gotta give
credit
to the
cast.
What's
in my water?
Yeah, exactly.
I'm just kidding. Let's hear what Jason had to say, because you were very funny.
He retweeted Jamil. This is gonna be the new soap opera for Black people. Lol, I'm telling you, it's shitting on the game. Hashtag for better.
Ooh.
Okay.
Ooh.
Listen, nothing against the game, because I'm actually on the season premiere of the game that's coming up at the end of this.
Oh.
But the first part.
I think it's just the game in general. Soap operas in general.
Dr. McHattie. He's a terrible person. He is a terrible person, and you don't want to know him. Mm. But, to the first part of that, this is
new
even for
opera.
Us watching it, because you know, I was talking with Kent earlier today, and it was like, I don't know what's happening tonight. Mm-hmm. I felt a little weird, what's happening tonight. And I think, you know, I didn't know that whole scene with you and Angela was in there.
Oh, yeah. It took forever to shoot
that. Well, Lauren and I were talking during the show, and we called it, what did we say, Lauren, a telenovela?
A negra novela.
And he corrected
us. Negra novela.
Yeah, you corrected us.
We invented that today. Nice.
You guys have good
buzz. We need a Spanish soundtrack.
Negra novela.
Oh, well, you know who gets down on the Spanish really well?
Who?
White boy Jesse.
Aquí yo.
What?
Aquí yo. Oh,
wait, here, Jesse.
No, no me dejes hablar así.
No, well, I was gonna say do a really nice compliment for our beautiful guest in Spanish.
Eres bien bonito.
No, you're not.
I'm like nervous. I'm on the spot.
Spanish.
He's got that girlfriend.
I'm like, that Spanish is locked for Melly, but you know.
Spanish, English, you get nervous when you talk to Crystal.
But your tu novia es latina, ¿sí?
Yeah, es de Mexico.
Oh, okay.
So he gets a lot more practice than y'all do.
Yeah.
You guys, speaking of, you know, that scene,
I thought she was going to talk in Spanish,
too. No, I'm not going to. No, no, no.
No.
See, I can't do the pit bull. I can't go from one to the other. If I'm going
to. What's up, Lauren?
No, just I wanted to, you know, give you credit for that scene, because I wrote in my notes, like, the power of friendship is so important. Like, I just went through a breakup, and if I didn't have my spicy Maddie and I didn't have my friends, you know, there for me, like, you were there for her in that scene, then, you know, it might have been the whole house.
Oh, my God. Lauren is just so...
And not just the car.
From the guy's point of view, I got to say, every time something goes wrong, I think, where are my clothes? Yeah. I swear, I am like... And I'm glad that Tyler Perry put that in there, because, like, as in a relationship, you, like, Waiting to Exhale is in all of our minds.
Yeah.
Like, that movie is just so ingrained. Right?
Like, if you mess up, the first thing you do is put some clothes in the car.
Right?
Why do we have to light stuff on fire? Like, what is that? Like, we have to just destroy your property. I mean, I haven't done it because I would be pretty mad if they touched my stuff. And if I was Marcus, I would have gone in there and lit all of her shoes on fire, too. But... I mean,
see, that's because
you know,
you're thinking like a woman.
I didn't know how bad it was going to get.
Wait, I'm sorry.
No, I didn't know how bad it was going to get since she almost tried to beat him,
I
too.
Thought he was going to do something back to her, though. He didn't do anything.
I was
so
worried
calm.
About that. Crystal, no, what were you saying?
Wait until the next episode.
Oh.
But Lauren, you and I were saying as well, though, when he was his silence.
Spoiler alert.
I know, spoiler alert.
There you go, Crystal.
His silence was very scary. Like, that's the worst thing that you can do to someone is just not communicate.
Especially for a man to just, like, when he's silent and you're, like, yelling and screaming and, you know.
It was good, though.
Is that
what
happened?
So
he was making
Lauren,
so
is that
dumb.
What happened?
Don't start.
Was this?
Yeah. Well, I'll do that. I'll stay quiet.
I just don't want to gloss over the fact that you're single. I just.
She's giving us two
can
vulnerable
we get, like, a lower
moments.
Third on there or something?
Right, wait, all
Lauren?
The single ladies.
Hashtag who wants Lauren now?
Wow. Lauren loves you.
I'm sorry.
Twitter? So would you guys, would you rather the silent treatment or would you rather them argue with you?
I think they should talk it
rather
out.
Her not be
I don't
crazy.
Talk I don't, out. I don't embrace either. Silence, yeah. I can't do, and I can't do the yelling and screaming either because I shut down. I just want you to talk to me. Can we just cry together?
Oh, yeah, that's going to
so
happen.
That's a,
she's living in a fairy tale.
I know, right?
It's a spicy world. No, but honestly, as a man, if you're going to, you're either going to make the relationship work or not. If you're going to take that responsibility, that's the stuff you got to learn.
Wait,
I'm telling you from
said,
experience.
Hold on. I wrote down something that Angela said to Marcus that I felt like was 100% disrespectful. I felt like she disrespected him as a man and disrespected just his masculinity and his essence altogether.
Oh, wow.
When they were in the beauty shop and she said, hold on, I wrote this down. Oh,
well, you don't do
sorry,
that
ASS, son of a witch. Ooh. You're a sorry, ASS, son of a witch. I don't want to, curse and stuff because we have some Christians in here.
Yeah.
But I felt like that was the most awful thing that you, like, to call a man sorry. I really felt like she was just letting him have it and she was trying to kill him, in his pride and his masculinity and they were just duking
it
out.
He held it together,
which
was great to watch.
I was waiting for him to slap her.
Another thing we had talked last week, I guess, with Michael about how the show is trying to show a different image of maybe the conversations the guys have. So they're in the TV studio. Crystal, I want your opinion on this because we talked about it a little. So Todd's doing the whole, like, oh, I could call her, a hot broad, a this, a that. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then the older gentlemen were like, wait a minute, you just haven't found that one yet. And, don't talk about my wife like that, And they were talking about you, essentially. So you were the one, So.
But they're giving us a different perspective. I love that he's showing black men in a positive light.
You almost always expect to see, on television until Tyler Perry comes through and saves the day. It's different now.
It's funny, too, because it's when you're dealing with the cable, anything goes, right? Mm-hmm. So, but there's also a difference when you're on cable with Tyler. Really, what I would have said in that scene, had it been an HBO show or something, was way different,
right?
what I mean? And so it's interesting. Even the response that Todd got was a lot more calm than he would actually get from a guy like me.
Right.
For real.
How would Jason Oliver respond to
it? That is not really good for AfterBuzz either. But, because there's all these levels. And what I love about Todd, it's interesting, people are kind of hot and cold with the character of Todd. But what Todd really does is Todd does everything that is against the man code.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Mm-hmm. And so it's really about Michael and Kent and myself teaching this young buck like what the man code actually is.
Yeah.
And there's the juvenile code. There's a juvenile.
Mm. Yeah, there's a generation gap there.
Which is fun and look what I did here with her and then I did that with, and then there's the man code. Those are two different codes. what I mean? So it's like, it's like once Rudolph gets to lead the sleigh, there's a different set of rules. And so we're teaching him, trying to teach him those different set of rules. And, that was probably about as heavy-handed as we could be with it on.
But, Ronnie, wouldn't you agree that after every episode we learn a lesson? Like, Tyler Perry sticks a lesson in there for us. He doesn't just let us see the drama. He's you're going to learn something with
this
drama.
And I feel like the good thing about his projects is he starts, I was realizing this is his third show on TBS. So, obviously, they're going to give him the freedom. Maybe the first two were more, it's the Meet the Browns and the House of Pain.
Network that believed in him.
But I'm saying it's cool. Just even like let's talk about Tyler for a second because I know he's watching. No, just the idea. And this is people who take themselves seriously in the world of acting or producing or whatever, and they want to be so authentic or whatever. Get some projects out there. Get some products out there. Show your talent, which he did. He put out these goofier, you know, sitcoms or whatever. Maybe we'll recap those later. And now he gets to put out a show like this, which is groundbreaking. And that is cool to me. And when we get to the social media report, we'll find out about his newest movie, which looks really, really good. So I guess unless anyone else has anything to say about the recap of episode 7, 8, let's do a commercial because I don't want to miss.
Put that number out there really quick if people want to call in.
You put the number out. You got it memorized, don't you?
No, I do, and it's a 424.
Philip is so good with
424-256.
Philly's got this.
1729. Call us if you guys want to talk to the beautiful Crystle Stewart and the beautiful Jason.
Oh, and before we hit commercial, I have a theory why she is so good.
Why don't we take a caller before commercial?
Okay.
Hey, see that number worked.
Okay. caller, make it good. What's up, caller? AfterBuzz. Hello.
Hey, how we doing tonight?
Hi, welcome.
Good. What's happening? Where are you from? What's your name? Let's talk.
From El Centro, California.
El Centro.
Named Adrian.
I called in
last night, actually, during one of the other AfterBuzz shows.
Oh, good. You're a fan. We appreciate that, man. You call in to talk to Jason, Crystal, or Spicy Amazing Mahdi? What's up?
I just have a question for all of you overall for this show. This is pretty much a pilot season, isn't it?
Crazy, huh? Yeah. That's what Jason just said. Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Oh, so I'm just wondering, like, since this is a pilot season, do you think that the other networks will look at this show and possibly pick it up? And do you think that this show will probably leave TBS in the future if it does get picked up by another show, let's say NBC or CBS or Fox?
Oh, I see what you're saying. Well, see, the way that works is that it's already under, let's say, for lack of a better word, it's under contract with TBS. So the only network that could pick it up right now would be TBS. And what you're going to see right now, this show, for better or worse, is coming out at a very interesting time. It's not normally the time that new shows debut. But so what you're going to see is coming up, you know, in the beginning, like January of 2012, you're not only going to see the first episodes of shows that have been on the air, like we talked about The Game and other shows like that have been on the air for 4 or 5 seasons. You're going to see those first episodes of the 2012 season, and then you're also going to see your new sitcoms. Just did a very interesting one actually called Apartment 23, which will be with Kristen Ritter. That's going to be a great comedy, and you're going to see a lot of the comedies that are coming out. The reason I bring that up actually is because they're all what we call one camera comedies. I mean, they're basically being shot the way that we're shooting, for better or worse.
Yeah, there's the Modern Family, Happy Endings is really funny right now.
The genres are blending, blending.
Well, and even I want to talk to the guy on the phone, Adrian. I don't think here anyone wants the show to go anywhere else like TBS. I do understand some shows, Sister, I guess it was. They were on one network, they went to another. Yeah. But that's more like once the show failed. Not my bad.
Don't say
fail. That's saying once a show doesn't get the push that it needs.
It's
you know, sometimes it needs a new life.
Look at The Game. The Game, you know, CW and that's a good dropped thing. It, BET picked it up, and it's a hit.
But
it's
right now,
hit.
I don't think anybody who is riding with this show, Tyler Perry's For Better or Worse, is worrying about that. TBS is where it belongs, and we will do our best to continue to give
great
recaps.
I'm
going to
tell you real quick. I know we got to go to commercial, but a real amazing story that Tyler did tell me about when he was getting the shows done was that what happened was that other networks wouldn't let him use the word God. They wouldn't let him say God.
What?
And this one particular major network said, "We love the show. We want it. But you can't say that." And he said, "Well, if I can't say that, then we're not doing this deal." And they couldn't believe it because no one ever says no to them. And TBS said yes. And
this is why I'm dying to meet Tyler at some point, because I think it's that mentality. A lot of people get so, Crystal, maybe you could agree. It's like they get so passionate, but like too much. And you've got to go for the right situation. And this is the right situation. Yeah. And it's exciting. We did a great recap. Let's go to a commercial. Let me
real
give you
quick,
my
I do want to say there are a lot of callers calling in. For those of you who, if you can't reach the line, keep trying. You know, we'll take your calls as they come
and
in.
And tweet us, too. tweet us at AfterBuzz as well.
AfterBuzz TV.
Let's do a commercial. Crystal, I have two theories why you are as amazing as you are.
Okay, we
got to
hear this.
Because this would be funny. We'll go to commercial. Okay. So she has hazel eyes, and I sort of have hazel eyes. So let me scoot over. Everything I say, Crystal, is crazy. But listen, so it's the hazel eyes, okay?
Randomly Ronnie.
Right? Okay. RandomlyRonnieJr.com. I'll blog about about you. Also, what makes her so cool is, I'm gonna blog about you. I know, right?
Girl,
I'm gonna blog about you, and I'm gonna teach you how to Twitter, which also sounds crazy. No, but you're a September birthday, and I believe you're a Virgo, if I'm right. I'm September 5th. You are the 20th. I know everything about her. We making it happen. Everyone clap it up real quick. We're going to go to a commercial. Tyler Perry's For Better or Worse. Continue to retweet, Facebook, all that good stuff. Here's a commercial. We'll come back with an amazing social media report and keep on becoming a girl.
I'm going to do some reading while we're at commercial.
through Maria Menounos' book.
Hi. I was once like you, a lazy, angry loner whose only joy was watching TV and surfing the net. And, like you, after I'd see one of my favorite TV shows, I'd be so excited and have so many questions that I'd actually have to talk to my douchebag coworkers about it at the water cooler. Then, I discovered AfterBuzzTV.com. AfterBuzz TV produces after-show webcasts and podcasts for TV series of all kinds, like post-game wrap-up shows for all your favorite TV shows. AfterBuzz TV hosts are industry insiders who break down episodes of shows, take calls from fans, and interview cast and crew from each series, with over 60 different aftershows, from Boardwalk Empire, to American Idol, to Vampire Diaries, to Real Housewives, and more. Now, after a night of TV, I can ignore my stupid coworkers, who I hate, and go straight to my desk and watch or listen to all my favorite AfterBuzz TV aftershows and have all the TV fan interaction I need. Thank you, AfterBuzz TV.
AfterBuzz TV. What do you want to buzz?
Hello. Welcome back, AfterBuzz TV. You are watching Tyler Perry's For Better or Worse, the recap show with myself, Ronnie Jr. That's at Ronnie Jr. Media, at Spicy underscore Madi. Our after buzzer slash actor on this great show, Jason Olive. Find him on Twitter there. And our special guest today, at Crystle Stewart, spelled C-R-Y-S-T-L-E. And of course, our social media mavens over there, Lauren T. Loves You, and at Jesse F. Daniels. We'll do a social media report, but you two social media people, can you guys maybe give her some opinions? She's gonna do a live tweet because here's my thing. You're on a Tyler Perry show, Crystle, and you're a Miss USA, and you do not have 90,000 followers, but yet Amber Rose has like millions. Like, right. I just can't do that, and that's upsetting me.
Can we take one time out before we get to the tweet? The tweet's a big deal, I understand that, but can I take a time out?
Oh,
is this Maria?
Yeah, that's Maria.
Yeah, buddy.
Oh my God.
You should get her to star
See,
on
now that would be something I would hashtag. Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, buddy. She's hot. She's says, gorgeous. Give your hair a break.
She does her own hair and makeup.
So what is this about? Yeah.
Oh, the book. This is, okay, as you know, Maria Menounos, this is her project, Kevin Undergaro as well. Well, this is one of Maria's other ventures, and it's a book that she just wrote called give me the exact name.
What is it to life? Every girl's guide to life.
And I thought Spicy Madi read it daily, but Jason now is becoming the newest fan, so. So there's another exclusive.
She gave Lauren and I free books. I just look at the pictures. We've been reading it. We started a book club.
It's just hot. I'm going to put that back.
Yeah, Crystle, you got to check out the book when you get a chance.
By the way, real quick, I got to say, Maria is a big fan of this show. She tweeted for you guys tonight.
I saw that.
So, yes.
Gracias, Maria.
So, shall we say it all together? Thank you, Maria. One, two, three.
Thank you, Maria.
Okay, cool. So let's get on to the social media report. Jesse, what is going on?
Well, real quick, right off the bat, of course, last week we talked about the For Better or Worse fan page showing us some love.
Oh, on Facebook, yes. Yes, they did. They post our videos all the time, which is great.
Yeah, exactly. We're on there right now. A lot of people are chatting. But also, Ustream tweeted us and pasted it on their Facebook as well.
Oh, is that why we got like 90,000 views in like a second? Yes. Thank you for that. Well, that and Michael Jai White and a lot of women like Michael Jai. And there you go.
That shirt scene. He's always naked in there. Yeah. He was taking off his clothes on this episode. I was like, he was hiding behind the little chair. I was like,
how's
don't hide,
again,
buddy? Yeah. Don't hide.
Yeah. How was that, that was spicy certified, right?
Right. Spicy certified.
Oh. He's like, woman. Whoosh, you know?
I leave the studio when he starts taking clothes off.
I'm like, bum, chicken, wow.
But yes, thank you to Ustream for showing us support.
Also, I want to give a real quick tweet from I Am Kiki Haynes. You guys had her on.
Yeah.
Kiki Tasha Coco.
Crystal. We got to figure that out by the end of the show.
Maybe she be refined like in Royal Crystal.
Yes, let's do an accent.
Ooh, do an accent.
So do Kiki Tasha Coco. Crystal!
Yeah, we got it.
We got it.
All right. Anyways, Kiki Keisha Coco. Kiki tweets.
Yes.
Keisha Richard and Jennifer hanging tough in Hollywood supporting Hills Toy Drive.
Oh, this is a great photo.
Hashtag for better. No, I just thought this was a great
this is
environment
amazing.
Picture.
You, hold on. Let's see if Philip can get the picture up here. The reason this is cool to me, you got a hit show and a lot of people, you know, the actors or whatever, some of them go out and just party. This was a great event. This was at Dre's at the W in Hollywood.
Yeah, the W.
And this was for Hill Harper's, actually, his toy drive.
Hill Harper does a toy drive.
And it's just real cool because we got to meet Kiki and, you know, here's actually the photo if you guys want to take a quick look.
Kiki looks gorgeous.
Yeah. I think it's nice that the cast gets to hang out. Like, you know, you guys are hanging out here today
especially
with us.
After you let the cast in, get your guest list straight, Dre's.
Oh. Wait. Where's the story? What's
I don't know.
Nothing. I don't even know who said that.
Oh, baby.
No, it's okay.
But either way, what do you guys think? You two as cast members, these are your friends, and these are the co, you know, workers, so to speak.
Is that Richard and Jennifer?
Yeah, that's Kent. Yeah, that's Kent. That's a Coco.
I'm calling them by their
character names.
I'm calling them by their real names. Like I know them that well. But no, to see your guys' co-workers out there just doing good events. And she tweeted that, so I think that was really cool. And she made a donation, I think, at the toy drive. Yeah.
Which,
nice.
Yeah,
the toy, I believe.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Kiki's sweet.
We did Nick
Gonzalez's
blood drive today. You got to give more than a toy. That's
You were giving blood?
You know what? I couldn't give blood. I know it sounds bad. I knew you were going to ask that, and I didn't... It's bad. Oh. I needed my blood today.
Okay. Sounds like we got to move
on
to the next.
Sounds terrible.
Sounds like we got
to
move
on to something else.
We got to move to the
very
next
selfish,
photo.
But
yeah.
I needed my blood.
I need
today.
My blood.
I needed it.
Okay, this
I wasn't
is great.
Feeling well.
Ooh,
this
I'll
is
actually
cool.
Let I'll toss to my friend right here on the couch.
Yeah, so you guys know sometimes I cover for NicoleBitchy.com.
You represent. Don't know sometimes.
Yeah. And Nicole actually posted about our girl Tasha Smith.
Yes.
She was on the cover of Be Entertained magazine.
Looking
beautiful.
Yes.
In the interview, she talks a little bit about her passion for her husband and, of course, working with Tyler Perry.
Right.
So make sure you guys click on that and check out Be Entertained Magazine's Twitter page, which is Be Magazine.
And I believe this magazine is just about out right now. So go on the Twitter, follow them. But I think it's cool. I think it's cool for a couple reasons. You guys, this show, as Jason said, it's sort of groundbreaking, genre bending or whatnot. But the support online. Now, Nicole actually got to work on a little, not a project with her, but something this week where she was talking about what her website stands for and represents. And it's like urban, you know, representing the female point of view. Mm-hmm. And then to see her go ahead and write about Tasha, who everyone loves.
Yay.
And I thought was even more cool because, you know, we do After Buzz, an online thing. The advertising
the ad
space.
Hello!
I just thought I thought that was cool how it ties in all together.
Yeah,
actually,
perfect.
Like when I'm on YouTube, you know, searching videos or whatnot, and then I see an ad for you guys, I'm like, oh, you mean the people we're going to go see on Friday?
Yeah,
it's good for me and Maddie. We love it. We get
really
geeked up about
love
it.
You guys.
And I think, what else do we have?
Anyways,
really,
one thing that I do really get geeked up on, and I appreciate that you guys do this for the cast, and I've said it before, and I'm going to say it again, is that, you know, you guys really do tweet while you're watching the show. Mm-hmm. You know,
yes.
We witness them. I'm, you know, witness for this, and that's really good because there's a lot of celebrities and there's a lot of things going around. You know, we heard the drama with Ashton Kutcher and stuff, and sometimes, you know, you have managers that take over, but it's really good to see celebrities handle it, even though you are new to it, and we'll teach you the
ropes.
Yeah,
let's teach you. Oh, wait, were you going to do a live tweet?
I was going to do a live tweet.
Real quick, I got to ask, because for the sake of everyone out there, on this ad it says Friday nights at 9. That is not the case, is it? It's at 10 p.m.
Well, 9 Central.
Oh yeah,
10 wrong. Eastern,
which is
10.
Yeah, 10 on the East Coast. Why wrong. We watch it on DirecTV at 7.
Major,
all right, so 10 p.m. East Coast, 9 p.m. Central, and so on and forth.
Yes.
Do not follow this ad. It is false.
but if it paid Nicole, then we are all good. What up?
Yeah.
Nicole, stop That's hating good. Nicole. Stop
let's,
hating
let's
Nicole.
Let's get that same ad on the AfterBuzz page, too.
Exactly. But going back to the vulnerability.
Vulnerability.
You can't even say it.
I am not having a good day.
You're all good.
Try it in Spanish.
Vulnerable.
Tell it on yourself.
Anyways, so Tyler tweeted, as many movies as I have done, I've never been the lead without a costume. To tell you the truth, I'm a little shy. I feel more comfortable behind a fat suit or old man costume. Is this 180?
No, this is actually from Facebook.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I must admit, I'm a little nervous about this one. Lol, so please, please tell me what you think.
You guys, I was done. When I seen that, I was like, I already am.
I'm watching.
Tyler Perry, here's my thing with him. It wasn't like I was following his career necessarily 100%, but obviously you know everything he does, right? But after I started working on this project, I have just been so much in this respect factor. Like, he's making the right decisions. He's going down the right lanes. Yeah. And for him to put put that on Facebook, and I double checked because he did promote the same trailer for his new movie called Good Deeds, which is out February 24th. He promoted that on Twitter, but on Twitter you could only do watch it, you know, and the YouTube link, right? But on Facebook you could be a little more open and honest, and he did say that, and I thought that was the coolest thing. You guys could speak on his character.
He's still humble.
For him to say, I've never done a lead except in a fat suit or an old man costume, and now I'm going to do it for the first time. So I'm sitting here thinking, I'm dying to see the trailer. Yeah. I want to see which role. What's he going to do? What's he going to do? Philip, do we have the trailer to watch? Or I could explain it. It's Good Deeds. It's
Keep going with it. I'll pull
okay,
it right
well,
up.
Okay, well, I'll explain a little. Oh, go ahead.
And going with what you're saying, it's like, so the man's on the cover of Forbes as the number one entertainer in the world, right? Ooh. So if you think of all the covers that are on Forbes.
Is that spicy? Is money spicy?
You don't understand the level of sexiness that takes you
Forbes,
to.
Yeah, Forbes magazine. I mean, GQ is cute, but Forbes, that shit is handsome. You know what I mean? I mean, Forbes is handsome. I mean, you know, there's a lot of details. That's pretty.
Yeah, pretty boy.
Forbes is downright handsome, right? Yeah. But I mean, you think of the, you know, Steve Jobs and all the other people who have been on Forbes. You know, have any of them come out and been like, "Hey, here's my flaws. What do you think?"
No.
I mean, there's not many people out there that are running the kind of business, the kind of industry that Tyler's doing, that are still open to the public and says, in terms of saying, "Hey, this is for you. I need your feedback."
Well, you see it in the show as well. I mean, it just seems so real. It's not over dramatic. I mean, you know,
it's
although
dramatic.
we see the
no, it's fight,
the you know, car being lit
realistic.
On fire. But I really enjoyed the scene where, you know, Marcus and Angelo were just talking to each other, and the fight, you know, starts off slow.
And then it escalates.
I thought it was just perfectly timed.
For me, better than anything with Tyler, and this is, like I said, I'm really starting to see all the projects he's doing, it's that diversity. It's like, I'm going to do the goofiest of goofy, and then I'm going to do the serious of serious, I'm going to do a dramedy, then he's going to, you know, be open on the Oprah show. Like, to me, I mean, that's why my blog is called Randomly Ronnie Jr., because I like to hit different lanes and try different things, and not any... It's not a lot of people out there that are doing that, and that's
real.
Really cool.
Because it's real, that's why.
We're going to look at the trailer in a little bit. Also, Phil, we're going to do a fun segment, which I call the doppelganger segment.
Oh,
I don't know if that's available, too.
Doppelganger.
But real quick, while Phil's like giving me the info on what we have available, Crystle said she's going to do a live tweet right now. If you guys want to, Jesse or Lauren, help her out. Like, what should she say?
We'll definitely put at Jesse of Daniel.
AfterBuzz, maybe. AfterBuzz TV, yeah.
Hashtag for better, because that's what we're talking about now. Okay. And then just express your feelings.
Yeah, like,
you know, are you having
Joseph
fun
was my real
show?
Life man.
I just got a tweet from ShellBell16, and she says, in the studio with Crystle Stewart, and she is hilarious. That's my little sister right there.
Oh, there's
a
little sister. She's the one, like, monitoring our time.
Yeah.
Thank you, Shell Bell.
Yeah. When I see it, I, like, just shut up, you know?
She's little sister slash producer today. Thank you, Shell Bell, for coming through. No, yeah, just get on Twitter, start giving your opinions. And, you know, obviously there's going to be those crazies that say those weird comments or whatever. But you know what? Use Twitter. Have fun with it. People like us who are watching your career, we're excited. We want to know, oh, I just did a radio interview. I just did a photo shoot. We want to know, hanging out with Kiki at, you know,
you
Mr. Chow. Have fun with this. This is your ride, you know?
Okay.
She's doing it now.
Okay.
I guess we're going to Mr. Chow now.
I'm going to send you a tweet a day, and then you just retweet it, or you tweet back. You just learn the whole, you know,
the whole
communication of Twitter.
The
culture.
The retweet. I was asking Jason, I'm like, okay, retweet. Can you write something with the retweet?
Yeah, you can put a comment with it. So somebody tweets something at you, and then you put retweet with comment or quote, and then right next to it, you're going to put your opinion next to it.
And I got to stress, she's on a Tyler Perry show. She was a Miss USA. She's cool as can be, and yet NeNe Leakes has got a million followers, and she's got like 900. I can't do it.
She's going to have a million by the end of the show.
I think I got a lot more now.
Well, you're on a hit show. That's great. Like, we definitely appreciate it. We love that. We're going to do the doppelganger thing in just a second, but you guys, this kind of touched me. It was a really cool trailer. Felicia Rashad is in it. Brian White is in it. A couple other people. Let's just take a look and see what the story is about. This is Good Deed, February. After the play.
My name is Wesley Deeds III. I grew up fifth generation Ivy League graduate, groomed by my father to be a businessman, to take over his company, groomed by my mother to be a gentleman. I was told where to stand and how to dress.
What would you like for breakfast?
Egg whites and oatmeal.
Egg whites and oatmeal. And what I would be doing for the rest of my life. My life is perfect.
No, you're in my parking spot.
Now, just be one second.
This woman left her child in the car.
I don't talk to strangers.
I can literally set my watch by Wesley. He always does the same thing, and he's always gonna do the same thing.
Where did you go,
Mike? No. I want to talk to you for just a second.
What kind of mother would leave her kid in the closet?
We're just going through a rough time right now.
Surely someone in your family who can be a caregiver to this
child. No, we don't have family. We live in the real world.
And I don't?
No, you do not. Tell me how much the gallon of milk costs. You don't even know.
You gotta be fed, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser.
It's one of our corporate departments. You can just live here as long as you need to.
This business wasn't even your dream.
You spend all this time making other people happy. You need to go and find what makes you really happy, because you have a good heart.
It's about me living for the first time in my life.
I'm so proud of you.
When it all comes down to it, life isn't about how much we get. It's about how much we share.
Good deeds.
All right, there we go. Does he not find the right projects?
When is this coming out, Ronnie? February.
It is coming out February 24th. I spent a lot of time. Learning. I now know everything about Tyler. So cool actors in it. And again, he's finding the right lane. So that's cool. But real quick with Crystle, we're doing live tweeting right now. If any of you guys want to retweet, this is what I wrote. We just took a photo. And I put recording a live podcast with Crystle Stewart at AfterBuzz TV. She stars in hashtag for better. And is awesome. And then I also put, hey, Spicy Madi, just because I know you retweet a lot. So I figured we could get a couple more hits, Crystle, if we do that. Right. So Crystle, here we go. I'm tweeting it. And that means you can retweet it and they'll all know who I am too.
So we just, it's a whole
phenomenon going on. I got a tweet here that I wanted to bring up because I actually know what it means. It says, I think that's funny.
Sometimes you don't know what your tweets mean.
You got to learn to read Twitter.
Maybe I didn't say that the right way. But it says, Crystle, this being your first big show, what is your rose and what is your thorn?
Ooh, I like that.
Now, do you know what that means?
No.
I know what this means.
I know what that means too.
No, because we do this every night at dinner. We ask our little girl, we said, hey, what is your rose for the day and what is your thorn for the day?
I'm tweeting that right now.
What is the
rose is the most positive thing experience, and the thorn is what was the least positive experience.
Oh, wow. That's a tough question. I mean, the most positive experience was working with Tyler Perry for my first big show, because this is my first show and he's really patient. So anytime I needed help or extra moments or something like that, he was there and willing to work with me. The thorn, wow. I guess just being my first show, you know, and have to really work hard and not knowing sometimes what to do or when to do it. But I had an amazing cast to work with,
and
me
you
and
got
Tyler Perry.
Big brother over there to help out too.
You can't tell all that this is your first show. I never would get it.
You should have heard. I don't know. I told her
we were sitting there watching tonight, and I went like, I hate you. I was watching these scenes, and I was just like, I hate you. If I was that good when I was like 22, however old you are, I'd be like 30. The black Tom Cruise by now. If I was that good. But you've done one thing before this.
Was it a soap opera? You guest starred on something?
Oh,
before?
I guest starred on Days of Our Lives.
That's just something?
At, you know, as Miss USA. It was like five.
You played yourself, because when I looked it up, I was like, oh, her, you know, Crystle Stewart playing Crystle Stewart.
Yeah, it was. It was actually fun, though.
I saw that episode, though.
How funny
I didn't realize at the time that, you know, a couple years from now that I would be sitting here with you. That's but you so looked funny. Amazing.
Thank you.
There's so much good vibes and vulnerability in the studio today.
It's like
three things. It's like recapping the show, vulnerability, because everyone said something goofy, and just, yeah, good vibes. What's on your mind?
You know a girl's hot when girls get dazed. You know what I mean?
Okay, here we go. Real quick, we're going to wrap it up in a second. I know, we could talk. Crystle, you come back, we'll maybe do a finale or a recap of the season or whatnot. But real quick, I want to do a doppelganger thing. Phil, if it's ready. The reason is we had Madi on our show, and I've been doing a bunch of shows with Madi.
He likes to make fun of me.
And we realized she looks exactly like somebody. Phil, do we have doppelganger number one available?
Not yet. I'm still, honestly, like, I get like 1,000 emails a day, so I'm still going through it.
Oh, gotcha. Oh.
Do we have any callers?
We should take at least one more
somebody
call.
Somebody call in 424-256. Oh, well,
real quick, let's take the moment to say 1,000 emails a day, and he is hustling. Philip, thank you for hanging with us,
To
battle the 1,000 and chill with us. I mean, Crystle, I'm sure you helped out a little bit being that pretty girl. cool. Crystle, we'll do this while he's looking. I'm not sure if we'll get to that segment, but real quick, this is what we did with pretty much Kiki also and Michael. Just kind of go down the group and we'll point at each person. Give us a little story, an antidote. We read the bios. We see them on TV and maybe we read their tweets, but we don't know them. So give me something about each person. We'll start with Kent, which plays Richard.
Okay, Kent. So Kent himself or Richard?
No, the actor.
Oh,
Crystal, we watched the show.
Kent is a loving man. He has, I think, two beautiful children, a lovely wife, and he's... very kind spirited. He's been working for a long time in this acting business, so he definitely knows what he's doing. And he plays Richard very well.
He plays Richard
very
well.
There we go. Kiki, who she was the first person to sit here with us that Jason brought in, and
love Kiki. Yeah, Kiki's so sweet. She's so charming and
adorable.
She's not Keisha at all, guys. In the show, she's not mean. She's not drama like.
She's not evil.
No, she's not. She's a complete
you were
opposite.
Upset at that, I think. I think he wanted her to be evil a little bit.
That's when you know you played your role well, and that's what I always say is when you convince me that this is how you are in real life,
then
you are an actor.
Exactly.
And you are darn good at it. I believe that when you step out in the real world, that you're going to act just like that.
Yeah.
And she mastered that role.
She really did. Because
she came
in here, the opposite.
She was just like a little angel. Yeah. I'm like, who are you?
She's sweet. And I like that she's a secure woman and she's independent. Yes. So look for Kiki.
Crystle, when you first did the show, some of the cast members did kind of shift around or whatnot. Did you and were you ever... up for Keisha also?
You were always Leslie.
I was Leslie.
Yeah, he saw you at the restaurant and you were Leslie. Okay,
yeah, I was
good.
Always Leslie.
And Michael Jai?
Michael Jai. You know what? One thing about this is this great actor, right? That's done everything in the world. He sends me this Facebook message saying how great I did on, I think it was three and four episodes.
Aww.
The sweetest thing, he was like, you did an amazing job. I like how you did this, and this. I just want to commend you for your work. And I'm like, Michael Jai is sending me this. Isn't
that
great?
That's amazing.
He's so supportive. He's so humble. And he's a good guy.
Of course, Tasha.
And
like
Miss Tasha, mm-hmm. I should call her Mama Tasha, even though she's not old enough to be my mom. But she's very caring and she's very passionate about what she does. She's very passionate in her relationships. She's very passionate with her friends. She's talented. She's an entrepreneur and she knows what she wants and she works hard to get it. And that's why she's. Right
I have
there.
A question for you about Tasha. Give us some inside dirt.
Okay.
The Angela that we see on mm-hmm. the show. Have you guys, as cast members, ever seen that side come out of Tasha?
No, the only side of Angela that I see that Tasha comes out is just like the loud, funny
version
of her. But she doesn't, she loves her husband very much, so she doesn't yell at him and all this. I mean, I'm not in her bedroom. But when I see them together, it's not like that at all. She loves him very much. And so the only side of Angela that she has, that she can be loud, but funny.
I was hoping she was
funny.
Just like that. No, crazy too.
Not at all.
You know, she often talks about how the loudness of, you know, that we get from Angela comes from the passion and that you can't have, you know, you can't have great passion without great love, basically.
Yeah.
And that, you know, I think mm-hmm. Tasha is more about the great love.
And, she loves very hard.
Yeah, she does. She does.
Flames burning.
Yeah.
Who's that other lady? You know,
Crystle.
Mm-hmm. All right.
What can we tell you about?
So Jason, there he is.
Jason.
He's sitting right here. Yeah.
And he's so great. I love Jason. One thing I like about him, I look at men and their character when they're with their wife. and with their children. He has a beautiful daughter, and he has a lovely wife. And I look at how he treats them. He treats them like very special, very kind, very warm. He loves them very much. So I knew coming in with me and doing this show that he was going to be very loving and very kind and treat me very well, because that's what he does with his family, and that's how he treats everybody. I'm so honored to be working
with
him.
Dude, that Rose and Thorn thing was pretty good.
Yeah,
you impressed me.
No, it's good to be working with him, because like I said, I can bounce back things. He always gives me advice. He's like, why don't you say this, Crystle? A lot of things that I didn't.
Okay.
Who was that?
We're shifting towards our doppelganger segment. So, Crystle, here's what it is.
So, here we go. Yeah.
Everyone
He's
who.
Using me as a guinea pig.
We have like 100 different AfterBuzz shows here. So, there's a lot of people that come in and host or whatever. And everyone looks like somebody. So, this is where we realize the doppelganger thing is a big deal.
I'm gonna
because she clearly looks like Adrienne Bailon from the Cheetah Girls MTV VJ. You think so?
I see it a little bit. The hair is different, but.
exactly. It's just different light.
I don't see it. Yeah, see it.
A lot of people.
It's similar.
I'm
no,
sure.
Adrienne is a beautiful girl, though.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, so you are.
That's a compliment.
So that's where it came from. And of course, like Lauren, we're looking at Lauren. We don't know who yours is. I'm thinking
Gabrielle Union.
Lauren Hill combination.
Lauren Hill.
Well, maybe I just want to talk about Lauren Hill.
Spicy. I may need to see you in some of the little lower cuts.
Garcelle.
Okay.
Did we zoom in?
Oh, definitely.
All right. Well, we'll get to hers next time.
I love you, Lauren Hill.
This one I've heard people say a couple times. So we found some photos that kind of showcase that Jesse, the Spanish speaker over there, he looks a little bit like.
I see it.
The funny thing is, I know that's Jesse, but who's that?
He's from Maroon 5, lead singer.
Oh, okay.
He's the judge.
No, I know the music. I don't know.
Yeah, he's the judge on The Voice.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I see that.
So
I think he looks like me, for the record.
Oh, you're the big star. And then so we were just going around the room and deciding who looks like.
There it is.
Rihanna.
I have to hear that all the time.
I get different people. It depends on what day it is. I get Rihanna, and then sometimes with the eyes, you get Tyra, or you get any light-skinned girl with
a career.
But Rihanna.
Fan page, Twitter, everything says Rihanna.
That was just funny to me because it's the look everything.
Top, too. That's funny. I think it's
Crystle, most people who win pageants or who participate in pageants or win Miss USA, they go into modeling. You didn't decide to do modeling? Went straight into acting.
Normally, you do the modeling beforehand. After the pageants, a lot of girls get into like journalism or something. Oh. Acting. Normally,
you would see Vanessa Manillo was a pageant girl. Susie Castillo.
Vanessa Williams.
Yeah.
Maria Menounos.
Yeah.
She normally models before.
They also get into Playboy.
That's a whole different breed.
I modeled before.
Shame on you.
Those
are the hosts only. You do not necessarily refer to.
Oh, there goes the disclaimer again.
That means one person talk at a time.
That's funny.
Yeah. So we just thought, put it on your Facebook page.
Tyler Perry was a genius. He took a model and matched him up with a model and put him on a TV show.
Yes. And it works. Yeah.
And it looked good.
Yeah, definitely. Well, Crystle, I'm going to let you wrap it up. Do you have any opinions, or we're pretty much out of here? Obviously, we could talk for a lot longer.
I don't want to go. I love
that. That is the best solicit ever.
It should be an after buzz.
The
after party.
Yeah.
For after buzz.
Oh, well, you missed that last week.
To talk about Crystle in this picture, let me tell you how amazing it is to work with her.
Oh.
To work with someone who knows who they are down to the very last millimeter of their personality. It's so amazing. You don't need to know how to act if you actually know who you are. You know what I mean?
Aww.
And there was one scene where it actually happened last episode, where it was the scene where the girls are all trying to tell her that I'm the worst guy in the world in the hotel, and then we walk into the kitchen. Well, we had taken this scene a couple times, and then finally it was about time for the last take, and I said, Crystle, I'm not gonna let you talk this time. She goes, what do you mean? I go, I'm just go with it. And Tyler calls action. And so we walk into the kitchen, and every other time I had grabbed the beer, and she had said her line, and I said my line, and she said her line, and we just like normal. But this time, it was actually the take that everyone saw. When she started to talk, I said, well, hold on a minute. You know, it was drinking the beer, just rubbing it in, making it worse and worse for her. And I literally had no idea what she was going to do, you know, as an actress. And man, she just picked up right on it and just rolled with it and rolled with it. And as you saw, that was the take.
Great. Yeah, that was the scene to use, but we already have a good connection, so we can go on stage and be like, okay, well, he's like, I'm gonna do this. I'm like, all right, I'll just flow with you. So if you have a good connection, good chemistry, you can follow each other's leads. Exactly. Yeah.
Well, I'm so glad you had a good time, Crystle. That's good.
Great.
How about us, Jason? Thank you for three cast members in 3 weeks for this great show that everybody's talking about. How lucky are we, Mari? Honestly. This is
so
just
lucky.
We are very lucky. Thank you to our social media people, of course.
Thank you,
thank you to Phil for getting 1,000 emails and still doing our show.
That's right.
We really appreciate it.
Crystle, thanks, TPS, TBS.
Do you have any last words for the fans that are watching you right now?
You know what? Thank you for supporting For Better or Worse, and thank you for supporting AfterBuzz TV. This is an amazing show. Catch them next week. Hopefully, we'll be back at some point. You have me back, hopefully.
That's right.
And
Hazel
and
Eyes.
They can follow you at Crystle Stewart.
At Crystle Stewart, C-R-Y-S-T-L-E, Stewart, and follow the Hazel Eyes, and at Jason Olive, and at AfterBuzz TV.
You got it, girl. You get it.
Yes.
Thank you guys so much. Keep on watching every AfterBuzz show. Follow her career. Crystle Stewart was in the studio. Jason Olive, thank you. Ronnie Jr. Media, Spicy Mari, our great, we have an audience again. That's good.
Audience.
All right. Thanks, you guys. AfterBuzz, please watch us. Facebook, tweet, and retweet. Okay, thanks. Bye.
Producers Kevin Undergaro and Phil Svitek, engineer DJ Jesse Janity, and the entire AfterBuzz TV staff, we would like to thank you for listening to the AfterBuzz TV network. If you have questions or comments, be sure to buzz us at info@afterbuzztv.com. And you can find us on Facebook or follow us on Twitter by searching for AfterBuzz TV.
Do the crystal.
Do the crystal.
Buzz you later.
The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only and do not necessarily reflect the views of AfterBuzz TV or its owners or principals.